Hello student, I am Deepak Mahale from Department of Mechanical Engineering. In this video, we will see Design of Shaft Part 2. In the previous video, we have seen what is shaft and types of shaft. After completing this video, student will able to understand formulas required for design a shaft. Design of shaft is done by mainly two bases. First is design of shaft on the basis of strength. It is divided into three different parts because shaft is subjected to twisting as well as bending moment. In that, first is shaft subjected to twisting moment only. Next, shaft is subjected to bending moment only. Third one is shaft is subjected to combined twisting and bending moments. Also, design of shaft is also done on the basis of rigidity or stiffness. Now we will see shaft subjected to twisting moment only. Diameter of shaft is determined by torsion equation. We have seen this torsion equation in previous subject SOM. The equation is T by J is equal to tau by R. In that, T is twisting moment or torque acting on the shaft. J is polar moment of inertia about the axis of rotation of shaft. Tau is torsional shear stress and R is distance from neutral axis to the outermost fiber. Now we will see for both the shaft, for solid shaft as well as for hollow shaft, the formulas which are required to design a shaft by twisting moment. In that, R is equal to D by 2 for solid shaft. For hollow shaft, R is equal to D0 by 2. D0 means outer diameter of hollow shaft, and DI means inner diameter of hollow shaft. Polar moment of inertia, J is equal to pi by 32 D raised to 4 for solid shaft, and J is equal to pi by 32 into bracket DO raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4 is for hollow shaft. We put the equation number 1 and 3 into the torsion equation. We will get this equation, T by pi by 32 D raised to 4 equal to tau by D by 2. After simplifying this equation, we will get the final equation as capital T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into D cube. From this equation, we can find out the diameter of shaft. In the problem, if we have given torque and torsional shear stress, then we can find out the diameter of shaft for solid shaft. Now we will see for hollow shaft. For hollow shaft, I have simplified the equation as T into R is equal to tau into J. In that, we will put R is equal to D0 by 2 and J is equal to pi by 32 D0 raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4. After simplifying this equation, we will get capital T is equal to tau into pi by 16 into bracket D0 raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4 divided by D0. From that bracket, we will common the D0 raised to 4. Then we will get the equation as capital T is equal to tau into pi by 16 into D0 raised to 4 divided by D0 into bracket 1 minus DI raised to 4 divided by D0 raised to 4, because we have taken D0 raised to 4 common from the bracket. After simplifying that equation, means we will put K is equal to DI divided by D0 as a constant for ratio of internal diameter to the outer diameter of hollow shaft. Then we will get the final equation as capital T is equal to pi by 16 tau into D0 cube into bracket 1 minus K raised to 4. From this equation, we can find out the internal as well as outer diameter of the hollow shaft. Now, we will see the shaft subjected to bending moment only. For this, diameter of shaft is determined by bending equation. That is, M by I is equal to sigma B by Y. This formula is also called as flexural formula. In that, capital M means maximum bending moment acting on the shaft. I is equal to moment of inertia acting about the rotation of shaft. Sigma B is bending stress. Y is equal to distance from neutral axis to the outermost fiber. In this, Y is equal to D by 2 for solid shaft. Y is equal to D0 by 2 for hollow shaft. Moment of inertia for solid shaft is pi by 64 D raised to 4. Moment of inertia for hollow shaft is pi by 64 into bracket D0 raised to 4 minus DI raised to 4. After putting the equation 1 and 3 into the flexural formula, we will get M by pi by 64 D raised to 4 equal to sigma B divided by D by 2. After simplifying this equation, we will get the final equation as pi by 32 into sigma B into D cube. From that equation, we can find out the diameter of shaft. Also, if we put the equation number 2 and 4 into the equation of flexural formula, then we will get the M is equal to pi by 32 into sigma B into D0 cube into bracket 1 minus K raised to 4. From this formula, we can find out the internal as well as outer diameter of hollow shaft. This is for shaft subjected to bending moment only. Now, we will see shaft subjected to combined twisting and bending moment. In that, we have to use the two theories, which are maximum shear stress theory and maximum normal stress theory. Now, we will see maximum shear stress theory. For that, having a formula as tau max is equal to root of sigma b square plus 4 tau square. This formula we have seen in the SOM subject. We know that in the previous slide I have explained T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into D cube. We can write down this equation as tau is equal to 16T upon pi D cube. Also, we have seen for bending moment, M is equal to pi by 32 sigma B into D cube. We can rewrite this equation as sigma B is equal to 32M divided by pi D cube. We will put this both equation into the equation number 1. After simplifying this, we will get the final formula as root of M square plus T square is equal to pi by 16 tau max into D cube. From this formula, we can find out the diameter of shaft which is subjected to combined twisting and bending moment. This formula also written as equivalent twisting moment TE is equal to root of M square plus T square is equal to pi by 16 tau max into D cube. From this formula, we can find out the diameter of the shaft. Now, we will see the second theory according to maximum normal stress theory. In that, having a formula for normal stress theory as sigma b max is equal to 1 by 2 sigma b plus 1 by 2 root of sigma b square plus 4 tau square. In this also, we know that T is equal to pi by 16 into tau into D cube. We can rewrite this equation as tau is equal to 16T upon pi D cube. Also for bending moment, we can rewrite that equation as sigma B is equal to 32M upon pi D cube. Putting this both equation into equation number 1, we will get the final equation as 1 by 2 into bracket m plus root of m square plus t square bracket complete equal to pi by 32 sigma b max into d cube. We can rewrite this equation as equivalent bending moment is equal to 1 by 2 into bracket m plus root of m square plus t square bracket complete equal to pi by 32 sigma b max into d cube. From this equation, we can find out the diameter of solid shaft. For hollow shaft, we have to rewrite this equation as pi by 32 into sigma b max into d0 cube into bracket 1 minus k raised to 4. From that formula, we can find out the diameter of hollow shaft also. Now, we will see design of shaft on the basis of rigidity. Resistance offered against the angular deflection of shaft is given by torsional stiffness or rigidity. Capital S is equal to torque upon angle of twist or angle of rotation equal to T upon theta. Theta means angle of twist. We know the basic torsion equation. T by J is equal to G theta by L. We can rewrite this equation as theta is equal to T L upon G J. From this equation and from the above equation, we can write down it as S is equal to T by theta is equal to T by T L upon G J. Capital T will be cut, then we will get the final formula as S is equal to T by theta is equal to G J by L. From this equation, we can find out the diameter of shaft. This is all for design of shaft on the basis of rigidity. Some additional formula also required for design a shaft as power. We have seen this formula in our theory of machine subject. Capital P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. In that, capital T is equal to torque or twisting moment in Newton meter. From this formula, we will get torque in Newton meter. But in the previous formula, we required torque in Newton mm. N is equal to speed of shaft in RPM. Torque transmitted by pulley can be given by capital T is equal to into bracket T1 minus T2 into capital R. In that, T1 is tension in tight side of the belt, which is given in Newton. T2 is equal to tension in slack side of the belt, which is also given in Newton, and capital R is equal to radius of pulley, which is given in mm. These are the formula which are required to design a shaft. In the next video, we will see problems on the shaft, how to use these formulas to design a shaft, means to find out the diameter of shaft. Thank you and happy learning.